king of the dot, put your money where your mouth is. KOTD S1, we in the West Division. It's about to get crazy. Final round. Rapper to my right, introduce yourself.
Stewie fucking Newton, you can't take shots. I do the fucking shoot. Fuck your baby mama long dick style. Shoot your baby daddy long clip style. You already know what time it is, man. Let's get it.
Battler to my left, introduce yourself.
It's Mad Flex, the ends. Happy birthday to my man Fredo. Third one of the season. I appreciate all you guys, man. Let's fuck it.
Hell yeah, that's what's up. Stewie Newton won the coin toss. He chose Flex to go first. Let's get it. Go.
You better call Tyrone. Hey, let me be direct. If you want smoke, I'm Tyrone. You're gonna need a breath. I slap you with a cig, Stewie. We know how your season went. Week two, you name flipped your way to a loss and showed growth right before face planting, you little chia pet. Look at me, Stewie. What the fuck did you think was gonna happen on the redirect? Marv won, my part done, but I'm still here to complete a quest. I'm all one. Before you speak to Flex, you need to understand there ain't no beef with Stu, but if there is, it's gonna bleed to death. Talk to me nice and let me offer advice. Cause the boss don't provide some sort of alternate prize for losing better than anyone who lost all the time. That's like being a loser. My name is Mad Flex. Stewie, you can't do what I do. You would just curb stomp the fuck out yourself once, and then you add reps, you bargain with life. The bark isn't bite. They say there's fighting this dog, but the fighting this dog is what made me the dog in the fight. Last time Newton had a glimpse at star power this big, the motherfucker was facing a part of the night. There goes your big moment, Stewie. You could have asked Lush. A season pass can get you washed when a monster arrives. Fuck a Stewie. It's playoff time. Give me Big Bill and not a watered down Mark when he's brought to the light. They all gotta die. I drop you quicker than the losses drop your bargaining price. You gonna white boy me up? That shit don't cause a divide. You might pull that shit off against Caustic or Lie, but there are people in this room who watch me offer to die with 9 of us and 30 cops, and that's the only time in hip-hop that I crossed any lines. I've been the man. Where the fuck they find you in the first place? Stewie came out lighter than my last winter tan. Switch it up. Where the fuck they find me up in first place? Now everybody follow me like Max Instagram. Oh my God. Black Alicia swag, I got the gift of gab. 0-2, roasted stew passed out in a holiday operation like Mr. Fag. Yeah, start switching lanes. 2 hours from now, hop on LTBR Twitter page and that shit'll say, Stewie unexpectedly winds up on death certificate like Michelet. I am. Consistently fire over the comp, this the Olympic Games. You can have 3 rounds to talk, then you stop. They get the doctor in to close them on a Sunday like a Chick-fil-A. Stewie, I don't take advice if you can't win a game. I'm 2-0, you 0-2, I flipped your record. I don't give a fuck you out here flipping names. That's time.
Time. Grand winner's on Stewie Newton, let's get it, king of the dot.
They got the number one seed, thinking he gonna get it done quickly. Mr. 150. Mm-hmm. Well, say hello to a nigga that's really 5150. They think my head hanging. They think my head hanging. But my comeback is golden. Red Ranger. Sugar free, making beats with a pencil. The lead banging, get left hanging. Dead in the ring is what you will do. They expect you to make it out alive because you believe you got the skill to. But if they feel you, took the edge, you did everything in your will to. Judas, the Black Messiah. Killing me, gonna kill you. So what's cracking? This a G-check. A right hit him, then he slept. Leaking. White boy on a red carpet. Ryan Seacrest. Yeah, I could have left his tee wet, but the arms useless. T-Rex. Y'all put too much stress on the joint. Hyperextension. I'm a knee flex. Try to hit my knee with a hammer, I'm letting it kick off I'm tired of all these jokes about Federal Way. We can go head up, cause repping my town is a state of mind. Fed up, y'all got me vexed. Y'all think flexible? Now his body's tripped. but I'm supposed to fear all this rapidy rapping. That sound like he's spazzing, but half of it's capping. Grab a gat and attack him, snapping his abdomen, stain on his shirt. Oops, accidents happen. This what happened? This what happened when you clash with a maniac who's strapped for the action? Street's disciple, Lazarus Savage, reach for the title. Don't go for the belt. It's a ladder I'm grabbing. I'm actually man, fuck all that shit. I ain't switching it for none. 30 in the 40. Stick it to my guns. No mad flex. Leave MF where doom at type shit. Comparing you to him just rewards you. They thinking that mad villain, but I see him as more food. I will floor you. I will floor you. Saying all this gangster shit while you talking me to death. I couldn't possibly forget how you jumped out your fucking pink skin when Bobby took his head off. You ain't partially a threat. That ain't flex and mode. G, y'all strong arm him with the text. A raw demon. A raw demon. But y'all thinking that he can never die. Y'all think this flex pussy, that's a Kegel exercise. So remember.
Time. Round two, it's on Madflex. Let's go. Can't see the S1.
Hey, yo, it kind of feel like Hollow's in attendance. Cause what you couldn't generate must get awkward when it's mentioned. Bro, this ain't about 100 grand. It's sympathy for upsets. You've been like a drum set. I'm symbolic. Understand, I did this for us, Stewie. Me for the fucking bag and you so you can make the playoffs. Disappear and make other plans. Go pack your shit. I'm from the Bay. I know where the Black Panther is. So I ain't got no problem putting Newton next to where Bobby Steele if he an activist. You get it, boss? You get it, boss?
I don't touch
you. Are you at a loss? Well, you got a knack for it. Stewie, stop the capping. Little homie ain't a graduate. It would take a fraud to see me burning down these motherfucking buildings as an accident. Catch up to me now, bro. I always kept a cool head in the ring like Al Snow. But his vital signs provided lines that sound like a dial tone when I said it, did it, showed it, and I proved it more than Brownstone. You already saw my first two. They count those. For now, though, Stewie, I'm just going to tell you how these rounds go. You ever buy some French fries and then it take a while to drive home? Stewie, all the salt in the season won't help if you out cold. I'm done with you. You have been so bad. Good would catch them off guard like a shovel pass into cover two. Stewie, I live by a couple rules. The first one is stop telling people stories about what you're gonna do. Cause the last time I saw them put a camera in front of dude, he said he would 150 me. Okay, come here, Stew. If the lens focus on me and it pans to this bum and zooms, it has to make adjustments between ladders and fucking chutes. Star power and bum recruits. I wouldn't mix with this fruit stew with a bag full of jungle juice.
Round two, it's on Stewie, let's go.
Word is you got seniority. But you're exactly how much of an OG if you was a rap grid freshman one whole last year before me? You can't big boy talk me flex. I done really gave blood, tears, and sweat though. Bless flow, put in pain so my name is one of the best know. I was the first one from this whole side to get on We Go Hard. So when I seen Grizz, Yak, Coffee, and real name Brandon get plates, I was like, let's go. URL in my state cause of me, and we putting on the best shows. So I opened up doors for the Northwest and the West Coast. I push a line every time. Give a fuck what they said or what they felt, bro. I don't need y'all to give me flowers that I helped grow. Hip hop lives in my heart. It's stored in it. Whether a big stage, living room, or fucking barn, I went to war in it. I can make any room look good. The core different. They feel you at a higher place on the tiers, but I say that we peers. Ain't touched half the stages. I've been blazing for years. Barely grazed the surface once you got grazing your but smack playing you, Stu. You URL Carfield. That's how they speaking on my run when I was offered 4 URL contracts and didn't sign one. They ain't been doing me no way. I been doing what I want. Yeah, my record ain't perfect. Just don't forget all the 30 clips. That's why they say Stu the GOAT. I curry shit, but I'm 0-2. Hey, but I'm 0-2. I gotta show and prove. So it's your turn for a death. Kill Mr. 150 and make the playoffs? That's
That's a tournament flex. I earn my respect. I earn my respect. And the hands active. Say I'm capping. Before you can speak, you slam faster. Throwing. MF. All around. Sam Jackson. You won't leave with your life. You gon' bleed here tonight. Thumb. Flicking the nose. Like Bruce Lee when he fight. I'll fuck you up. I will fuck you up and tell you I'm fucking you up. Like, preaching while I work you. Don't you ever, like black parents when they trying to beat you till you purple. Nah. Talking over the beats like Moesha in the journal. Time, nigga.
Rampage on flex, last round, let's go.
That crazy battle, let's go. Nah, fuck all that, let's speed this up. Stu, is this a pregnancy? Then where's the bad blood you should have had? Cause we've been waiting weeks. You out here talking about you cut the cord with Smack, you ain't cut shit, you ain't make the team, you walked away and couldn't win, so now it's a mistake to leave? Why won't Stewie die? Bitch, why won't Stewie thrive? Stewie came alone and he's still out here proving how death came in threes. It's too late, I didn't waste one bar on complacency. They ain't the state police, you need to reinterpret what not making a statement means. Who are you? I don't need your name, you got a space I need. Bitch, if I even sense a chip on your shoulder, I'll be giving it to Ace Amin. Light him up. Same way I've been permanently lighting up the number one spot with a no next to the vacancy. Don't play, Stewie. This ain't a game, Stewie. You going out on a limb, I'm going out on a limb. I'll break your bitch ass arm off and hand it back to you like waving. You'll be swinging that bitch. You'll be swinging that bitch all the way through where the exit be. Even your plus one get cooked like a dozen at a bakery. Then I'll put a couple blades through his cheek until he Raider theme. Fuck him. I'm on the top floor. We don't need to talk more. What you need is a fucking seat and some popcorn. On what account? I don't know. He lost more than Scott Storch. Consistency is key, and Stewie walk around with locked doors. It's not just skill, it's a poor commitment. I wanted kills, so I overdid it. OJ Simpson, I bet you pissed that all of these awards are missed. Listen.
Crazy.
What? You a liability on stage, but I've been steady balling off the chain like fourth in inches. I'm saying you coming up short, and they hired me to show the distance. Now you know the motherfucking difference. I'm different. Should I copy him and fail? What, I'm just out here noodles all the time without a commissary sale? The only way I could consider you an op is I'm the rattlesnake bite, and on the flip side, you're a cautionary tale. I am a motherfucking showstopper. I've watched you play Washington more than the Globetrotters. I've watched you write excuses and arounds why you ain't go farther. I've watched you play leagues against each other like a soap opera to be a flake that winds up on the bottom like Goldschlager. I'm sick of the nonsense.
Oh, shit.
Time, fuck it, man.
Final round, it's on Stewie New. Let's get it, KOTD.
Yo. Yo. It's a theme that's underlying. Stewie, Brian, Family Guy, it's funny kind of. If you win tonight, I hope you win it all. You deserve it and it's unsurprising. Catch him outside and see Stewie, Dragon Dog. Where my money, Brian? I put it all in my bitch account. Oh, clever kid. FaceTimer with the Drake on him. Bring me all the money and hundreds and I'ma let him live. When she seen how it rolls on a pussy, bet she came faster than she ever did. I got a sick brain, this shit's strange. Dismember him and his bitch frame with a big blade. I've been chopping their bodies up for 6 days. Jagged knife, remind you of a saw. Squid games, switch lanes. Switch lanes. To the judges who gotta resurrect your image. Changing the winners at the last second like we can never tell the difference. Counting me and fake slips, but missing Caustic and Cody's, But we supposed to trust y'all to make a level head decision? Better yet, I get it, cause when it comes to this judge, you'll never catch me slipping. I should rob one of y'all. So you know what Rosenberg feel like, and it's hard times. I'm one stack away from killing one of you motherfuckers in real life. This a different kind of level? So y'all can't reach me, and dog can't beat me. Ain't gotta punch him. A little slap, but have him on stage sleepy. Each hit him.
What?
Each Hit a photo promptly, the fist is origami. I'm living in the trenches, so them wicked stories haunt me. I spit it way too vivid, so the killers know I'm mobby. I put my pastimes in new work. Dickie Motasanti, you copy? Do you know how much of your whole flow you gotta change to get with me? All this lyrical mirror, you think you making history? That shit light. I'm talking LED light. Save your energy. Attach the K. Attach the K with a bayonet, then clap the Drake and lacerate the arm poke. I made him vaccinate. Don't get mannish or catch an off-guard shot. The shit candy, big cannon. It been through war after war with me. The shit I'm with, standing and do your bitch scandals. I'm talking all in her walls, doing big damage. And she said you never spit in her mouth. Bang, wish brand, nigga.
Time. Make some noise for Mad Flex and Stewie, y'all. We'll be right back with the judge's decision. Yeah.
Man, man, man. The final lap of the season, and we've got some unexpected twists and turns, and some things that we're not quite surprised about.
Lot of twists.
The fan vote went to my man Mad Flex with a score of 58-42. However, with a score of 144-141, Stewie Newton wins the battle. Give it up to both of them.
What up, what up, what up? It's your boy ARP, and we are back for the judging of a very, very close battle. I see that the fan vote came in giving it to Flex. Looks like the judges gave it to Stewie. Cannot be mad at that. This was a very, very close battle. See, the thing about these two guys, aggression, performance, presence. They definitely both got presence up there. And they could both rap their ass off, so they kind of neutralize each other out. So for somebody like me, the way that I started to judge this battle, I tried to find little moments that they were both giving us to divide them. Try to find somebody that's going to, you know, run off with the round, find some type of standout moment. If I was a little bit critical, I would say that, you know, this battle lacked that a little bit. Somebody that just gave me that super wow factor, I could say, yep, he just ran off with the round. But because they were just like consistently on their shit, it was real, real neutralized out on both sides. I feel like Stewie did stick out just a little bit more in the second and the third round. No, I'm sorry, not the second and third round. The first and the second round. I think that Flex's best round was the third. Even his angle, it kind of like responded to what Stewie was talking about, the content that he was doing in his second, the whole URL angle and everything. So perfect timing and perfect layout for that. These guys really, really had a close one. Can't be mad at anybody going with either one, but I'm going with Stewie 2-1 taking the first and the second.
Yo, it's your boy Mark Jamgo, aka Mr. Shake the Building. We back. This was a crazy back and forth, man. This was a tough one to judge. First and third, very close to me. I did agree with my constituent ARP salute. I did have Stewie in the first round as well. Super razor sharp, close round. A couple of the bars for Stewie in that first kind of edged it for me. The 51-50 right out the gate. The flex emoji, strong arm with the flex fire with the text, crazy. So I had Stewie in the first round, 10-9. Second round, I think this was Stewie's best round, man. I think this is a little bit of an awkward and abrupt ending for Mad Flex, but in my opinion, not enough to give an additional deduction other than just losing the round. So I also had Stewie 10-9 in the second round. The give me flowers that I helped grow, fire, Stew to Goat, Curry-ish, the Mr. 150 to make playoffs, and that's a tournament flex. He had a crazy, crazy second. So 10-9, Stewie in the second. Third round, this was Mad Flex's. This is what I wanted from Mad Flex all three, although his first round was crazy too. This was my favorite and his best round in my opinion. Plus one get cooked like the dozen at the bakery, crazy. Play Washington more times in the Harlem Globetrotters, fire. Stewie was consistent and good, but I think this was Flex's best round. Flex 10-9, total score 29-28. Winner Stewie Newton. Salute.
Yo, what's good, y'all? No Mercy, aka Swave Severs, Drunk Nephew. Y'all know what time it is. I gave Stewie Newton this battle, man. This was really close. Like, I mean, all three rounds really close. I gave Stu the first and third with a 10-9, and I gave Flex the second 10-9. I got to commend them for being two of just the hungriest guys in this tournament, you know, in terms of like all of the newer talent, you know, and just putting on a standout performance. This battle to me was one of the best ones of the the season so far. And they both just come with it every time I see them. So salute to both of them. But I had Stewie 10-9 in the first and third, Flex 10-9 in the second round. So I give it to Stewie 2-1.
Family man, family affair. Real quick, you know, we in and out. This is a debatable 2-1. This can go either way. First off, 2-1 debatable, easy. First one, Flex first round was cool. Stewie came out swinging in the first. I did get Stu the first. He started fast, slowed down towards the end, but he did enough to win the first. He won the first round, 10-9, Stewie. Going into the second, I did like Flex material. That symbolic shit, catch you off a guard like a shovel pass on cover. That shit was fucking nuts. I loved it. Stewie came out, had a couple shit. He was solid, but my only thing was fucking Flex. It wasn't a choke, but at the end of the nigga round, it was weird, bro. I went to the screen like, you got something else? What up? Yo, spit something. And he just stopped. She was weird. I ain't gonna hold you. And that was the round I'm still fucking debating on. I was back and forth, but I did get through that round 10-9. And to the third, I think Flex took the third. So 29-28 by 1 point, Stewie, 2-1 for the rap heads, but 29-28 in the judge. I'm Ghost family.
Stewie, I can't lie. I'm mad as fuck right now, bro.
Man, what's going on, bro?
Where was this? After the first, I don't know if you peeped, after the first round, I said to you, I was who's this guy, Stewie?
I mean, you know what I'm saying? This is the energy I've been meaning to
you
bring.
You could have been a contender.
You know I know, man. You know what I'm saying? But you feel me? That was the whole point of coming with that energy today, though. You know what I'm saying? Just to show y'all, like, you feel me? I kind of wasn't really. I had to get back to my regular self. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, shout out
bro,
to Matt
Flex.
You back
on your bully shit.
Man, you know, I just had to brush some shit off. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's all a war in the mind. You feel me? And you know what I'm saying? Every day is a battle when you look at it like that. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes life can 2-1 you, 30 you. You know what I'm saying? But you got to get off your ass and 30 that shit back. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm just back in the groove, man. I'm feeling good.
You definitely got off your ass and got back up on that ass, like, for real.
Yeah.
And the thing is this, like, something I notice about you, with all battle rappers, but you being the poster child, essentially, you and Jay, for your entire region.
That's a fact.
For the Northwest.
That's a fact.
And when you battle out there, the aura is different.
Way different, I mean?
There's a level of comfort.
Yeah.
But I feel like we saw Seattle Stewie in L.A. today. Is that an accurate assessment?
Yeah. I mean, you know,
you didn't have the gas chamber behind you, but you were still...
I was comfortable, and I felt like everybody could see I was comfortable, you know what I'm saying? I was confident in my material and what I came with, you know what I'm saying? Like, I knew I couldn't go out 0-3, man.
Right.
You feel me? I knew I couldn't go out like that, you know what I'm saying?
And what a W to claim, but against the number one seed in the division.
That's a fact.
That's crazy. And I'm not sure if you're aware of, I told you the score was 144-141, but apparently every judge voted for you.
That's dope, man.
It's a unanimous decision.
That's dope.
Except for
the fan vote.
The C-hat. You feel me?
Like, yeah, the C-hat. Yeah, for sure.
I want to take out the H from chat and just call them cats.
they cat it up.
Yeah, they cat it on your flawless victory.
Yeah, but regardless of that,
you know, and you know, you stood up against a very, very formidable Mad Flex performance.
That's a fact.
It's not like you caught him slipping.
Not at all. You feel me? He did exactly what I prepared for him to do. You know what I'm saying? Like, this dude's undefeated. You know what I mean? And in his first battle, he put up 150. Like, you can't sleep on somebody like that. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely not.
You feel me? Salute to Matt Flex, man. One hell of a competitor. You feel me?
Yeah. I'm beyond proud.
Appreciate it, bro.
Moving forward, I know that people definitely are going to want to see you. If you don't make the playoffs, it's still very situational at this point.
That's a fact.
A lot of circumstances.
That's a fact.
You're going to determine if you advance or not.
Yeah.
We'll take a look at the scores later on. But regardless of that, we need to see you in S2, bro.
Yes, sir.
I need you to run that S2 for
Yeah. We're going to be back. You feel me? We're going to talk about it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Act like Cook Crack in the Reagan era, baby.
Come on, man.
Any parting words this season before we sky up out?
Hey, man, just salute to everybody that fuck with me. Salute to everybody that don't fuck with me, too. Believe it or not, everybody's the reason why I keep it going. You know what I'm saying? You already know what it is, man. Highway business. Gang.
And my boys, Flu Flam and TikTok. Make sure you tap in with them.
Hey, they just banned me, so you got to follow me on my backup account, @Stewie in the Trenches. You know what I'm saying?
You know the vibes.
Gang.
Man, fuck all that shit. I ain't switching it for none. 30 in the 40. Stick it to my guns. No mad flex, leave MF, we're doomed, mad type shit. Comparing you to him just rewards you. They thinking that mad villain, but I see him as more food. I will floor you.
Me for the fucking bad.
Well, Matt Flex, congratulations, because you secured your playoff berth.
Okay.
So you did what you had to do. You know what I mean? Like, the path has not been derailed. You're still moving forward. It is what it is what it is. And there's still a good chance you may leave this bracket with the highest score.
Yeah.
So.
First and foremost, man, fucking Stewie did great, bro.
He really did.
I'm very happy for Stewie. I'm glad that I could be happy for Stewie, like, in this situation, because Stewie has been a class act through the whole tournament.
Absolutely.
Handled some really rough circumstances with complete fucking class and just, like...
Class and grace.
Even if it's at my expense, I'm very glad to see Stewie have this, you know, this moment, because he deserves it. He's one of the best in the world, so I'm very glad he put on. He put on.
And, obviously, this didn't affect you moving on. Do you feel like the judges made the right call?
It doesn't. It's preference, because, like, in some ways, like, I'm sure I had an argument, but I will say he
was close. 144, 141.
Yeah, it's. But I'm not going to argue against a win for him. I did a lot of things right, but I think he really popped the crowd. You know, he had those, I mean, which is kind of always the case for me. Either I got the crowd early and they're moving with me, or sometimes it kind of just, like, doesn't resonate and then I'm moving on my own. And today was the first time in the tournament I kind of had to move on my own.
Season. Do you feel like there was a bit of a, it almost worked against you, the standard that you set for yourself? And it's like, you know, like, it takes a lot for you to impress people now, because they already are impressed going into it. So you have to kind of, like, you know, do extra backflips, do a fucking, you know, a Christy Yamaguchi triple Lux in the sky to make him even, move the needle.
I think it's a case-by-case basis. You come out any given day and you don't know what the dynamic of a crowd is going to be. You don't know what a room's going to be like. You don't know how people are feeling. But, like, today, it was a day where Stewie gave them what they wanted, man. So, like, I have nothing else to say in terms of, like, deserving or not deserving. I feel like both of us did some good shit, and I'm glad that he got this moment. I'm definitely glad.
Absolutely. I mean, like you said, whether or not it has to be at your expense.
Sure.
Now, is your mind state instantly switching now for the playoffs?
Well, here's the, like, I'm training for an Ironman right now, and in 2 weeks. So I've been doing 4 or 5 hour workouts a day.
Only five? You fucking lazy.
The problem is I don't want to die, right? I don't want to go out there and do this fucking race and die. It's 140.
You said you were
miles.
Dedicated, bro.
I know. I should be doing practicing, but the problem is, like, I'm
going to
be very ready. If I make these playoffs, still, I don't know, like, the details of it, but, like, I'll be ready and I'll be focused, and I was focused today. I had a couple moments where I was kind of like, okay, like, you know, I wasn't as in the pocket as I wanted to be. And I know what that looks like. So today, you know, it's a learning experience. I feel good about it. And I'm happy for Stewie, for sure.
How much is physicality a factor when it comes to battle rapping for you? Like,
it's hard when you're doing, like, for the long workouts, it's like, all right, I do those. And then, like, it's hard to, your brain doesn't quite function as well with the process. But to tell you the truth, I felt ready.
The outcast running, sprinting while screaming your lyrics at top volume in order to...
No, I always do it. Like, I actually have a little carpet.
International.
No, because, like, back in the day, I used to pace and practice. And then I realized that you only get comfortable while you're pacing. And then you pace around and you're like, no, you don't want to do that. So I have a little carpet. I'm like, you can't leave the carpet. That's the only place to practice, because the rest of it, you just, like, are adding anxiety into it.
And the carpet don't gotta match the drapes, lady. So what I'm curious about is, do you feel like there is another factor at play with Stewie, kind of like, kind of the polar opposite, the inverse of your scenario? Like, the bar was low key set for him a little bit lower.
Yeah.
Because our expectations were not.
Yeah. Well,
not
which is
not that we don't know that
you
Stewie's
know what
a
we're
monster,
talking.
But
well,
with,
you know how this goes
within the context of the season.
If you look at me and Stewie and I'm 2-0 and he's 0-2, that sets a very inaccurate bar, because
right.
It makes him look like a permanent, you know, he's got a zero and I've got an all, and it's just like that's never ever going to be a true barometer of what a battle between me and Stewie's going to look like, because he's always going to be competitive. He's really, really good at this shit. So
Yeah, I mean, I will say that the bars are going to be set. That's part of this narrative, right? You've got your favorites and you got your underdogs. So to me, you just got to play the role that you're stuck in. And right now, I feel a little bit grateful to kind of be more like to be set more in like, all right, let's get me out of these favorites and now I could just go to work, you know?
What do you feel like was your strongest performance of the season thus far?
Fate. Fate. I mean, I like Fate and Bobby both, but I think I really, you know, I went to work and I did it on short notice. So I felt good about it. But I'm just proud to be here. I've had a great time with this season. I'm grateful that you guys all fuck with me. I'm grateful for everyone in the chat. Happy birthday to my man Fredo. And
happy birthday. Feliz cumpleaños, LG.
To my favorite new dad out there.
I can't tell who's who, him or his son. They're like...
They're the same.
Yeah.
They're the same.
He went to the lab for that. That's a clone.
Yeah.
That's a clone, baby.
they just took some of his stem cells and just
went... That's a C-loan and V-loan, bro. Come on.
Or it's almost like he had a baby, you know? It's like...
Almost
like that.
No, but the genetics are strong.
Very
in the South Pacific.
Very saying? Strong.
He not playing. Flex, any parting words before we sky up out this biatch?
Yeah,
and I'm gonna see you in the playoffs.
I hope so. Yeah, we'll see. I'm grateful for everyone fucking with me. Please know that I'm here to win this shit now. So let's get to these playoffs. And I'm going to work, man. Stay with me. We're gonna keep doing it, and I'll be back better than ever next time.
Gangland.